afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. If I could please ask you to take your seats. A very, very warm welcome to you all. My name is Sarah Schwab, and I'm the Director General here at Les Roches, and it's my great honor to welcome parents, partners, family, and friends of our graduates to this very prestigious event. At this ceremony, we will witness the presentation of degrees for the following programs: our Masters of Business Administration, our Masters of Hospitality Leadership, and our Postgraduate Diploma. Now, before we get started, a few housekeeping tips. If you can please pop your mobile phones on silent. If anyone has a Samsung phone, we're going to ask you to turn that one off. I'd like to also inform you that we have an official photographer. He's going to be taking photos, and has been taking photos actually, yesterday and all through the day today. The pictures can be downloaded free of charge from the website. All of you have one of these little business cards on your seat. Please follow the instructions. It's got all the details you will need to access those lovely, lovely memories. And if anyone would like to purchase some high-resolution pictures, that's also possible via the website. Ladies and gentlemen, honoured guests, may I please ask you to be upstanding to welcome onto the stage our graduating students for December 2016. Graduands, please be seated. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure, like all the staff and faculty here at Les Roches, you would all agree that our graduands look simply splendid today. Let's give them a big round of applause. As you well know, Les Roches is a special place. And you may also know that round here we say that Les Roches is not just a school, it's a way of life. And it's a way of life that is made particularly special by the number of international folks we have from all over the world that make up our wonderful student and faculty body. Now, here on campus this semester, we've got about 96 nationalities. And I'm thrilled to say, even with a small and perfectly formed set of graduands here, we still have almost a third of those 96 nationalities represented. And if you look behind me here, you'll see that we've got some flags that represent 24 of the nations that are represented in our graduand body today. Now, we are a school, so I don't know if they told you that we've got a test. No? Okay, right. Well, let's see how we go, right? So, who wants to start me off? What's the first flag here on the far right-hand side? Argentina! Oh! I think this side of the room has it for now. So we've got Argentina, we've got Azerbaijan, we've got Brazil, Bulgaria, Canada, I know we've got some good ABC, China, Costa Rica, and this next one's Greece, okay? We've got Hungary, India, I couldn't see that one coming, Indonesia. Now spot the intentional mistake, out of sequence, Switzerland. And we've got Italy. Mexico, Palestine, Peru, South Korea, Taiwan, we've got Turkey. Zambia will truly have A to Z, but Vietnam brings it home most times. So thank you so much. And it's time really for us to move on to the very critical part of our proceedings. And it's my great pleasure to welcome to the stage a lady who doesn't actually need too much introduction. She's the fearless leader of Les Roches Worldwide Group. She works tirelessly on behalf of the school. And I'd love to invite to the stage Madame Sonia Tata, Chief Executive Officer of Les Roches Worldwide.
Thank you, Sarah. Honored guests, dear parents, family members, faculty and friends here present, and dear graduating classes of November 2016. It's a great pleasure for me to welcome you to our beautiful and memorable ceremony at Les Roches Global Hospitality Education in the Swiss Alps. We ordered the beautiful weather for you, so. I'm thrilled and honored to have you join us for this wonderful day of celebration. Today is a special day for Les Roches community and for all of us, as we all come together to congratulate and honor our sons and daughters for their high achievements and outstanding results. Our sons and daughters have embarked on a journey with Les Roches 1 year, 2 years ago. They have aimed high, they have stretched their capabilities, and excelled in their studies. For this, I'm very proud of them. This is an exciting milestone for them. They might be closing one chapter in their lives today, and yet there will be many open pages ahead of them, full of meanings and opportunities for their future. As they are taking a new path into their future, moving into the exciting employment world, I'm confident that they will always remember having cared enough for one another, having helped each other at difficult times, having made each other feel special, and having been a friend that others can lean on. Each one of them can stand tall today and say, as per Abraham Lincoln's words, I'm a success today because I had a friend who believed in me and I didn't have the heart to let him down. Actually, at reflective moments like this, beyond having mixed feelings of pride, emotions, relief, sadness a little bit because you live in Les Roches, of course, there is nothing to be done except to be thankful to people who made this happen. For this, I would like to iterate this quote slightly differently for our graduates to say, I'm a success today because I have parents, I have family members and teachers who believed in me, who trusted me, who challenged me at times, but also were there for me to help me rise to success. So my sincere thanks today go first to parents, to family members here present with us, to faculty, who played a crucial role in making this journey a success for our sons and daughters. Thank you for your commitment. Thank you for your dedication and support on behalf of Les Roches community. Secondly, I would like to pay tribute to our graduating students. I'm very proud of each and every one of them, and I'm honored to address a few words to them today. John Maxwell said, a leader is one who knows the way, who goes the way, but also who shows the way. My humble message to you, dear graduates, sons and daughters. As you step out of Les Roches doors, make sure to create your future. Make things happen to yourselves. Lead your paths and fulfill your dreams. Whatever you do, do it with your heart, with perseverance and passion. Whoever you become, be the people leader others look up to and others follow. Stay true to yourself. And finally, wherever you go, leave your marks, make an impact. It's only then you can succeed in your careers. Along the way, however, and most importantly, don't forget your humanity. Bring your human side to your business world. Give to people, care for people, and make a difference in their lives. Hospitality is, after all, is about people. So, dear graduates, I would like to wish each and every one of you, from the bottom of my heart, a bright future and the best luck in your personal and professional lives. Congratulations again, and thank you for being part of Les Roches family. Thank you for working hard. Thank you for being together as well as a community. Now comes the time for you to go out there and be the leaders, be the ambassadors. So thank you again and congratulations.
Madame Tata, thank you for those inspirational words. So it's time to move on to a very important part of the day, that is the awarding of our degrees. May I please invite Dr. Alain Imboden to the stage to present our MBA students.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's my great pleasure to announce today the MBA graduates of 2016-2. I met them in January this year as their lecturer in research methods. Research methods is a fascinating subject. Okay, I rephrase. Research methods is a necessary subject for them to complete their dissertation. And we talk about interesting things such as research philosophy, research approach, and strategies. And I know you all want me to go on forever, but we don't have the time for that. But we talk about one thing, which is an hypothesis. An hypothesis is an assumption, and you assume that a certain cause has a certain consequence, basically. And I don't know if you remember, but the first time we met, I actually formulated a few hypotheses. I didn't maybe call them that way, but still. I said that the fact that you're enrolled in this program will have some consequences, basically. So I just want to quickly test a few before I call you your names. And I'm taking a bit of a risk here, but we'll see. It's not very scientific thing. The first one, I think I said that, you know, now you're enrolled in an MBA, you will see that you will live an experience that will be made of ups and downs. So if you agree, then you just can't make any noise of ups and downs. So you think, what was it? Was it just ups? Downs as well. Okay. The second one is that you are going to live a very intense year. And again, I just want to test if it's good. Yeah? Okay. And the last one is probably the riskiest of all, you know. Just assume that you will live an unforgettable experience. That's risky, you see? Yes? Good, thank you. Okay, so far row, please stand up. Sorry, I forgot. I call Madame Tatar, Dekujin Argobel of the Education Laurel Walsh, and the Dean of Graduate Studies, Dr. Diamant. That's really give the degrees to the students. The first students I will call are on an MBA with a specialization in finance. Cayoli Maria from Argentina. Devas Castillo Maria Fernanda from Mexico. Medikasari Vinda from Indonesia. And Nguyen Thi Van An from Vietnam. Pater Ria Vipul from India. Rock Brand Campos Randy Manuel from Costa Rica. The following students will receive an MBA with a specialization in marketing. And we have Chen Ko Ting from Taiwan. And Davetas Alexandros from Greece. Faro, please be seated. Now we'll ask the knee row to stand up. These students will also receive an MBA with a specialization in marketing. And we have Kanna Reza from India. Kigwe Sharwan Bawunji from Kenya. Lee Win from Vietnam. Let Timin Phun Phariton from Thailand. Yutsu Wei from Taiwan. Lu Yongki Alexander Tsun Liang from Mauritius. Manley Varunjash Ashish from India. And finally, Sudevijit Kosol Napat from Thailand. Niasal, please be seated. I call now on stage Dr. Annelie Gallery-Caro, which is responsible for the MHL program in La Roche.
So I have a small batch. I will do a short speech. First of all, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to congratulate our graduate students, all of them, not only MHL students, but all of you. Congratulations. And I'm very proud to present the third batch of the Master in Hospitality, the Master in Hospitality Leadership to you. My dear former student, this year was a real challenge for you, all with your fears, your disappointment, your joys, and successes. You learn that true leaders are not those who are humble, are those who are humble enough to admit their mistake. You learn that being a leader doesn't mean being a good leader. We know that there are toxic leaders as well. Today is the last chance to give you advice. So please, when you start your new job, remember to stay yourself and to trust in yourself. But always replace excuses with effort and laziness with determination. Never forget where you come from, what you have achieved, and what you want to achieve. The only one who can stand in your way is you. To all of you, MBA, PGD, and Master, I wish you all the best in your future, and please keep in touch. Master graduate, please stand up. Agarwal Ananye from India. Al-Sayek Sanad from Palestine. Hu Shuai from China. Yape Skullman Michelle Rose from Canada. Mamadova Nigar from Azerbaijan. Rivas Kufantis Ana Carolina from Peru. With distinction. Shamnad Mohammed from India. Svetanova Vergini from Bulgaria. Dear master student, please be seated. Now I'd like to welcome on stage the PGD program manager, Mr. Frank Koenig.
Good afternoon. I don't know why it raises a smile. First of all, thank you for the wonderful evening last night. In a way, such evenings are met fathers, mothers, grandmothers, boyfriends, girlfriends, all sorts of things. And it makes the journey complete because, in a way, you get to discover beyond the student who you really are and your family and friends who have supported you. So it was a great evening. Thank you very much. I think we all enjoyed it. It was a great time. Now, everything comes in three, Have you discovered that? Every good thing comes in three. Three little things. The three Billy Goat Graph. The three Musketeers. You wonder when I'm going to stop, yes? The three graduate programs. And of course, I've known many of you in the different programs, but in particular, the postgraduate diploma students. Three good decisions you took. You decided to change career, you decided to come to Switzerland, and you decided to come to Les Roches. For that, so in many ways, there's more in three and everything, but please make sure there's always something. You know, each of you is individually very strong. As a group, you can be very strong. When you join the industry, make sure that your employers know who you are. You have so much to contribute. You will soon discover it. Don't be shy. Get there. The industry needs you. You chose this industry because it has potential. We have a guest. Another thing, when you leave us, of course, you have known each other for a few months, a year, some longer, and keep in touch with each other. Really use the alumni to your benefit. Use and work with them. The future student will look up to you. Your career path, you will be an inspiration to the future students. Perhaps you, former students were an inspiration to you. So please keep in touch amongst each other, sometimes with us, and then good luck. Now to the important thing. Voila. So, near side, please be standing. So these are the postgraduate diploma students, career changers, and the first student I will call is Benjamin Grosh Pirapong from Thailand. And he graduated with a distinction. Charun Rajanista from Thailand. Shavda Radhika Kiran from India with distinction. Chen Hangyang from China. Chuan Fei Han from Taiwan. Fang Yujong from Taiwan. Far side, please be upstanding. Thank you. Grazioli Francesco from Italy. Hung Chai Ying from Taiwan. Kailola Metanoi Ekarista from Indonesia. Kim Chang-gun from South Korea with distinction. Krasnenok Antonina from Ukraine. Liu Fangyu from Taiwan. Mathur Anirudh Swarup from the United Kingdom with distinction. Morera Benelis Stephanie from Brazil with distinction. Please be seated, thank you. Near side, please. Your turn. So, Nanjunda Nishiri from Thailand. Rajat Ilakan Yakil Raj from India. Retiska Rekha from Hungary with distinction. Roy Nikhil from India with distinction. Scott William Graham Finlayson from Canada with distinction. Solanki Shanu from India. Wu Yuchun from Taiwan. Yu Jiangtang from China. Thank you very much. Madame Sonia Tata, Dr. Diamantis, thank you. And I will welcome Mrs. Hanshua back to the front here. Yes.
Now, graduates, we can say that. Fantastic. You've had the most thrilling time here at Les Roches, and I'm sure that you have a few mixed emotions about saying au revoir, but let me leave you with something to cheer you up. You know, as one story is closing here, there's another one opening, and you know what that is? You can now say that you are part of one of the best, most thrilling, enthralling networks in the world, which is Les Roches Alumni. Ladies and gentlemen, graduates, it's with enormous pleasure that I introduce you to one of our fantastic alumni colleagues, Mr. Eric Bouff. Eric has had an illustrious career since leaving Les Roches. I'll let him tell you just quite how long ago that was. He's got some incredible brands on his CV. Disneyland, Paris, Millennium and Cotthorne, Marriott International. I was interested to learn that Eric was actually general manager at the Marriott International property at Charles de Gaulle Airport. I can imagine, Eric, there's one or two interesting stories you can share with us over drinks a little bit later about that assignment. But Eric's now running his own operation, so he's giving back to the community in terms of offering consulting, coaching, and training programs which support those working in the hospitality, retail, and leisure industries. And he's got a particularly interesting focus, something that's very close to my heart, around motivation and engagement for individuals and teams. Eric, we're absolutely thrilled that you're here, and it is my very great pleasure to invite you to the stage. Thank you.
Dear Mrs. Tatar, dear Mrs. Schwab, dear faculty members and teachers, students and parents, this is a very special and emotional moment for me. because 27 years ago, I was sitting in those chairs, right here. And I never would have thought I would be standing here today. My name is Eric, and I'm a 1990 Winter Batch graduate. As you can imagine, I am honored and proud to have been asked to come and speak today. And when I see all of you, I cannot help to think of my graduation back in June 1990. And I cannot help to think of all the people that made this place so special to me. Faculty members, students and friends. And as a matter of fact, this is the first time I come back since my graduation day. So I'll let you imagine how I felt when I arrived this morning, this afternoon in school. All those memories, those pictures. As a matter of fact, when I walked into the building, I was looking out for my mates, Eduardo, Jonas, Pauline, Steve, but they're not here. They're all around the world in their respective countries. And maybe that's the first learning I have from La Roche. The day you graduate, your school friends becomes a powerful international network that will serve you just as it has served me for the past 27 years. So as a matter of fact, 30 years ago in December, I was packing my bags to come here in January 1987. At the time, there was only a three-year course. We had 1 year in service, 1 year in kitchen, and 1 year in management. I guess things have changed. And it's great to see how the school grew and developed. Back then, this building did not exist. It was under construction. Yes, if you go to the kitchen, you'll see the picture of the old building that's just like today. And back then, we had to live in Montana and take the funicular to come down to school here every day. And you know what? I have so many stories I can tell you as a former student, and so many stories I cannot tell you anymore. But I'll be very happy to share that with you after the ceremony. If you want to hear about the day we missed the funicular to come to a housekeeping course, and we decided to run down the hill with this much snow. We thought it was a good idea. We never made it back. Or I can tell you about the enormous snowball fight we had in front of Petit Paradis. And I do remember that Mr. Ortiz and Mr. Sherry participated. So you probably don't know who these people are, but they were just amazing teachers we had at the time. I can also tell you about our love for typewriting courses. Because back then, there were no computers. We had to learn how to type menus, memorandums, and essays. Whew, I'm glad things changed. Well, these wonderful years in school, I was surrounded with great people. And just like you today, when I graduated, I had a profound envy and desire to conquer the world. And I was ready to apply everything I had learned in school. So real life started, and it's been an incredible journey since then. It took me and my family around the world, Taiwan, mainland China. I went back to France, United States of America, Belgium, Dubai, and I worked for amazing corporations. I worked for the Ritz Hotels, IHG, Disney, Hyatt, Millennium Hotels, and many years for Marriott Hotels and Resorts. As we say it, I climbed the way up. I started as a food and beverage supervisor. And I went all the way up to a hotel general manager at the Marriott Charles de Gaulle Airport Hotel, where I was there for over more than a decade. And 4 years ago, I decided to change my life, and I became an entrepreneur. So I opened my own company. We're a Paris-based consulting firm that helps organizations enhance their guest experience by implementing hospitality luxury codes and developing the power of intentions. I have never forgotten that everything that has made me successful until today started here in Bluch. And La Roche not only educated me in hospitality, but it also shaped me to become who I am today. 27 years ago, after having graduated, I am still grateful for the school that have taught me the following things. First thing is, nothing comes easy. Even what seems to be a simple task needs precision and attention. I learned this the hard way during my kitchen years. You can talk to Mr. Stockley. Think global and act local. With all my schoolmates and friends from all around the world here, I very quickly learned that there are so many things that unite different cultures, that it allows uniqueness to stand out and shine locally. And also, aim high and be bold. Remember that, aim high and be bold. Because you are trained to be among the best, and you have the capacity to shape the future of our industry. Now, of course, the quality of the education and the unforgettable camaraderie anchored me in my quest for success. And now, with some years down the road, I can share with you some wisdom I learned by experience. Regardless of which field you will choose to operate in, whether it be operations, sales and marketing, maybe it could be development, or maybe you'll go into another industry because we are multifunctional. I will share with you what we call the three intentions that shape luxury and hospitality, and that will allow you to reach your goals and become who you want to be once you leave the school with your diploma, maybe tonight. The first intention is about elegance, balance, and refinement. Just as hotel buildings, hotel rooms, and hotel outlets must be designed and orchestrated to be beautiful, harmonious, and impactful to the guest, you as a future hotel executive, you will need to activate your intention of presence. You will need to be visible, you will need to be poised, to be elegant, and always show the best of yourself in all occasions and events. Hospitality is a business about interacting with people. People that we serve and people that we manage. And we always need to remember that we are impacted by what we see, what we hear, and what we feel through our senses. Senses lead to emotions, and emotions are the roots of guest experience. The second intention I want to share with you is the one that creates great hospitality experience, is about providing value and uniqueness. Recurrent added value is what makes your guest and what will make your team members feel special and unique. And therefore, this will generate loyalty and commitment to your brand, to your business, and to your property. Apply this to yourself and intentionally make sure that every decision and everything you do will add and generate added value to others. This is an indisputable and a very powerful marketing tool that will lead you to success. The easiest way to add value is to give first, and then you receive. This might sound very simple and naive, but as you will take on your first jobs, employers will be hiring you on your La Roche education, on your profiles. And then they will want to see results before to give you your first promotions. Now this is easy to understand, but the challenge is to not forget it when you will be successful down the years. When you will be successful, and because this works both ways, either with your guests or with attracting powerful collaborators. Remember that if you give added value, you will receive in return. And this is a never-ending revolving wheel of loyalty and commitment. The third and last intention that shapes remarkable hospitality is the intention of tenacity, or the ever-ending desire to go further and beyond achievements. What makes a successful company, brand, or organization is the fact they never settle for less. And they know that whatever is unique today will be copied and will be soon outdated tomorrow. This intention of tenacity means that you will always need to be one step ahead and never take things for granted. There's a French saying that says that if you want to reach the moon, you need to shoot for the stars. After all, you are graduating from one of the very best hotel schools in this world, and you have been given the tools to shape the future of our industry. So you can only do that if you are able to go further than what is commonly expected of us. Now, success doesn't happen by accident. It is always the result of proper planning, hard working, and a great network. As a matter of fact, your network starts here, today, in this room. Starting tomorrow, you will all go your own way and start building your career and your legacy. And you might be competing against each other for jobs. And you might become competitors in your work. But some of you might even give jobs to others. Of course, we all know the quality of alumni from La Roche. But regardless of what happens, your first network is right here in this room, together with a school alumni network. And regardless of your graduating years, there is something special that makes it that we always help each other. You know, my first clients, when I became an entrepreneur, were alumni from La Roche. And when I went to Dubai later on for a consulting job, it was the La Roche community that helped me source the market and helped me open doors so I could be successful. I always make a point to help fellow alumni whenever possible. I always attend La Roche gatherings because the network started here needs to carry on. And I have always received much more in return than I have always given. So you know those three intentions that shape great hospitality, the intention of elegance, the intention of added value, and the intention of tenacity, are very powerful tools that you will find in almost every successful organization. And those tools will lead you to become the successful hospitality leaders that you are destined to be. So to conclude, I want to congratulate all of you for graduating today. This is a very important moment in your life, and you can be proud of your achievements, as it marks the promise for a wonderful and successful career. I, for myself, am happy to see that the future of our industry is secured with fine-looking individuals, ready to move in and to continue to keep alive the La Roche spirit around the globe. So thank you for your attention. Thank you for inviting me today. I am so happy to be present here, and long live the spirit of the 2016 MBA, Master of Science, and PGD graduates. Congratulations.
Mr. Booth, thank you so very much for your amazing speech and also for the inspiration to the students. I hope actually that they did appreciate your speech, and we do as well. So we have actually a small token of appreciation, if I ask our director to please stand, and to thank you actually for your effort to share your words of wisdom as well as actually for your traveling to us today. So thank you so much. Without any further ado, I just like to congratulate you all. You reach a point actually to your life and to your educational career. I hope it's not the end for your educational career. In a couple of years' time, to see us again, hopefully with a PhD here at La Roche, but let's hope for that. We do have actually some special awards and some special prizes for those students that they did go a little bit above and beyond what was expected. So. We have the top academic student during the semester one for the MBA is the value of 500 Swiss francs offered by the commune of Radon. I would like to ask kindly Ms. Madeleine Bocat Mayor to come to the stage, please. And Patel Ria Dipul from India. Congratulations. The second actually prize for the MBA for the Masters of Business Administration is the most progress made. So we have actually Gwen Saron from Kenya, and is going to be offered by the Selecta, and I would like to ask Dr. Eccles to come to the stage. We have here two prizes. One is actually the amount of 300 Swiss francs, and also a solid gold coin with a value of 240 francs offered by the UBS. So thank you, Sarah. Congratulations. The second category of the prizes is the is for the Masters of Hospitality Leadership students on the far end. Is the top academic student, is the prize of 500 Swiss francs offered by the Guardian Security, presented Mr. Raoul Ray. And the student is Rivas Ana Carolina from Peru. The second prize is exactly the same as the MBA, so it's the most progress made. 500 Swiss francs, offered by the Blancival, presented by the program manager, Dr. Darioli, please. And we have Svetanova Vergini from Bulgaria. So we go to the blue hats, to the postgraduate diploma. So for the top academic student, the 500 Swiss francs offered by ImageWare, I would like to ask Mr. Guni, the program manager of the program. And we have Rziska Reka from Hungary. The second prize, the most progress made along actually 1 year, two semesters, offered by the Carage Le Parc de Adressier. I would like to ask a colleague of mine, Mr. Pablo Garcia, to come to the stage. And Ms. Kranzeneko Antonina from Ukraine. And of course, it's for 500 Swiss francs. We come now to the part of the ceremony that we're selecting a student voice. To do the valedictorian. Now, because I had the difficulty of selecting a voice, I selected three voices. So I would like to ask the voice from the PGD program, the voice from the Master of Hospitality Leadership, and the voice from the MBA to come to the stage.
For joining us on this very special afternoon. It is an honor for the three of us to be representing the graduating students of 2016. Before I begin, I would like to thank the people on behalf of everyone, without whom we wouldn't have been here today and we wouldn't have ever gotten this chance. Our parents, all the ones present here, but also the ones watching live from all around the world. Since we first got here. Pre-MBA was all fun and games. And before we knew it, everything hit us all at once. From having 5 papers to hand in within 1 week, to working long nights to try and finish applied, there were days where we had so much to do that giving up just seemed like the easier option. I am so proud that despite the stress, tears, occasional arguments, we kept going and came out stronger. Look at where we are now. Living on a mountain leaves you with no choice but to see each other every single day. Whether you like it or not. It also means that we are now each other's family away from home. I still remember on our first day, and I thought, wow, it's only 16 of us. And now how glad I am. Even in this small class of 16 people, I've met some of the most amazing people that I know. We started off as classmates, went on to taking trips together when we barely knew each other, and now we finish off as a close-knit family. Thanks to Lahosh, we now share unforgettable memories, including our amazing Chicago trip. The MBA program has helped guide and shape us to become the hospitality leaders of tomorrow. Now, as I stand here, I'm filled with bittersweet emotions and would like to thank everyone for making this year memorable. To our father in Switzerland, Dr. D. For his constant support and having our back no matter what. Mr. Rosen. Jokes woke us up every Wednesday morning. All our dissertation supervisors for their unbelievable patience. And Mr. Ginning, from being my PGD program manager to my teacher in the MBA, the one thing that hasn't changed is how I leave every conversation with you with the biggest smile on my face. Where we will no longer see each other every day. We won't even be in our comfort zone. But today, we celebrate the accomplishment of one goal and work towards achieving our next. MBAs of 2016, I would like to tell you, what we will reminisce about a few years down the line won't be how we stayed up all night to finish a paper or long meetings where all we thought of was food and sleep. We shall look back fondly of this time that we spent together and the lifelong friends that we made. As we now embark on our next step, I would like to remind you that nothing is impossible. We have gained the knowledge, and now it's time to go on, take the next step, and use it to make a difference. And I would now like to pass my word on to Carolina from the MHR.
Thank you. So the time has finally come to celebrate 1 year of studies, memories, laughs, arguments, but overall to celebrate our graduation as postgraduate students of La Roche. I still remember the first time I got to school, such a long flight from home. At the beginning, I was feeling quite lonely, being so far away from my family and my friends. Everything was new. But I met my amazing class of 8 people, the MS class, and I stopped feeling that way. Because I realized that we were all here alone, but we were alone together. We're all from different parts of the world, different cultures and different backgrounds. It wasn't easy at all times, but with a lot of effort and motivation, through leadership, we managed to make it here. Again, special thanks to all our family members who made this possible for us, for supporting us always, and of course, the singular help from Dr. Darioli, who was and is still here to help us and to listen to us. So all the assignments, group projects, dissertation, exams, everything is now in the past. And it is time to celebrate our achievements and to cherish this exact moment forever. I would like to leave you, dear MS, with a final thought. Keep moving forward in order to make your dreams come reality. And don't worry about falling in the way, because failure is a part of life. But what really matters is standing up and never ever giving up until we reach our goals. There is no such thing as small dreams, because all dreams become big once they are real. Thank you. Now I pass to my word.
Thank you. Around 1 year ago, I received a document in which encased a red file that read, "You're in." La Roche is not just a school, it's a way of life. At that time, I didn't know what it meant. I had a lot of questions. But I didn't have to wait long to find out the meaning.
January 2016, Hotel Ida, Crown Montana. 26 strangers meet in a room on the topmost floor. Do you know how hard it is to remember more than 20 names from all over the way, from all over the world on the first night? Well, it was the first challenge. And then gradually I started to know more as the interesting personalities behind the names revealed themselves. And so our sweet story has begun. If I say we spent 1 year together, it doesn't seem that much. But when I start thinking about all the joy and tears we shared, that 1 year seems to be forever. Hotel Ida, the shuttle buses, the weekend brunches, the fish farm, the one-yard trip, the practicals, and even preparations. With our amazing group, teachers, and program manager, Mr. Gooning, this 1 year wouldn't have been the same. It is said that when one door closes, another one opens. Don't be afraid of new challenges, because even the unknown can bring something extraordinary. I wish that each person in this room finds a way to happiness, joy, and fulfillment. On behalf of the postgraduate group, I would like to say thank you for our teachers, the Laurel students, parents, and friends to support us during this wonderful year. We feel honored to be a part of the Laurel community, the Laurel family. I promise myself one thing today. I will forget the word goodbye. I believe we'll see you soon. Thank you, goodbye.
Carolina, Maria, thank you so very much, and another round of applause for the amazing Christmas. Very sadly, it comes to the end of the ceremony, and before I could leave you for the goodbyes and the hope au revoirs, I can be able actually to thank a couple of departments, individuals, that they made this event possible. First of all, our academic team, secondly, our academic secretaries, thirdly, our graduation department team, that they could be able actually to put this amazing graduation together. At last but not least, to our faculty, but also to the program managers team. Dr. Darioli, thank you so very much for your support, Mr. Gooning, and also the management of the school. Thank you for being here. It's the time of the ceremony. I would like to ask you please to stand up. And I would like to congratulate the batch of actually in November 2016. Congratulations and all the best of luck. Please graduate, please.